principle number three, that the bearer of the Qur'an must understand that having doubt in the Qur'an is kufr, it is disbelief. Allah Ta'ala says in the Qur'an, تَنْزِيلُ الْكِتَابِ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ مِنْ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. The revelation of the book without any doubt is from the Lord of the world. There is no doubt in the Qur'an. And the bearer of the Qur'an must have yaqeen and should have yaqeen in the Qur'an. And in this process, people traverse the path of knowledge from different points. And somebody could be in the deepest shades of dhulm, but then comes closer to the light, tadrijan, slowly, step by step. And as those steps, his yaqeen increases. And in a sense, the bearer of the Qur'an may be also traversing that path. But the bearer of the Qur'an must understand that there is no space for doubt when it comes to the Qur'an. We must not have any doubt when it comes to the having any doubt in the preservation of the Qur'an, in the oral or written preservation of the Qur'an. And there is no doubt in this. The Qur'an has been preserved and memorized the world over, the exact same text memorized by all Muslims all over the world. The Qur'an has been preserved in text form for centuries the world over, in every geographical location in the world. Nobody brings a Qur'an that is different to the Qur'an that we read. It has been preserved. However, I just want to make one point here, that having doubt, generally speaking, is or can be defined as having the feeling of uncertainty or a lack of conviction. This is what doubt is. And from a spiritual perspective, doubt is a disease of the qalb, of the heart. And sins committed by an individual affect their ability to attain yaqeen. And this is where the bearer of the Qur'an must be careful. What you learn can be affected and taken away from you. That understanding, that feeling, and that deep understanding can be taken away from you due to sins. So be careful of sins. May Allah Ta'ala forgive us for all our sins. Hence, there is a direct correlation between the sins and the ability of the qalb as an organ of understanding of the metaphysical. Yaqeen is the polar opposite of doubt. Doubt causes anxiousness, and yaqeen brings about happiness and contentment. However, a side note here, that having uncomfortable thoughts to our mind does not contradict yaqeen. These could be just off-the-fly thoughts or something you're just thinking about, or somebody says something that triggers something in your mind. That in and of itself does not contradict yaqeen. And the Prophet ﷺ was asked, verily, we perceive in our minds that which any one of us would consider too grave to even express. And the Prophet ﷺ asked, do you really have such doubts? They said, yes. And upon this, he said, this is the manifestation of faith. And Imam An-Nawawi explains that these thoughts paradoxically indicate strong iman. They are protective of their faith. And because they feel that it's bad and wrong, that shows that there's something in them that indicating that shows that this is wrong. That's why they feel uncomfortable. Had there been no iman, they would not have felt that anxiety. So hadith number 3 of 40 in this principle is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is reported to have said that having doubt in the Quran is kufr.